Looking for the cheapest coins on the internet right now, head on over to my sponsor AOEAH.com. They have super cheap coins. You can get a million for such a steal. Head on over, and of course, if you use code Poodle, you can get a discount off your order at checkout. What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today I'm gonna be going over a few updates. We have zero chill news, we have a pretty big title update coming, as well as the LTDs for today and some other stuff that I do want to go over. So first, guys, we have the screen here. There's gonna be some outdated stuff they did just repost today, so I'll go over it briefly for people who haven't seen it. But before I do, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, turn the notification bell, give it a big thumbs up as always, and of course, comment down below, let me know what you guys think of the news, what you guys think of the LTD. And guys, if you want to check out Underdog Fantasy, which is a super cool daily fantasy app, head on down below. I will have a link and a code for you guys to use. If you use my code, you will get up to a free $100 on your first deposit, which is just a bunch of free entries, so enjoy. But yeah, Weekend League Rewards. November monthly Weekend League Rewards are targeted to release on Thursday, December 2nd around 5 p.m. So that's today around 5 p.m. Rewards are based on a 4-week win requirement. Game Day All-Stars. Still kind of ridiculous that we aren't getting our Game Day All-Stars updated till tomorrow. Now, if you guys don't already know, that stuff was back in Thanksgiving. I know it doesn't sound like, oh, like what, a week, you know, a week and a half. It is a crazy long time to get guys who are already low, like 90 overall players to 92 overall players, right, that are already behind in overall. So give them another week with zero chill right around the corner. Also, Ultimate Season is targeted for a refresh on Wednesday, December 8th. Reminder levels reset back to zero. These are the monthly rewards, guys. So if you did place in the Legend, which is 60 overall wins for the 4-week period, you have 4 Legend Fantasy Packs and 2 Touchdown Packs. I guess you kind of get half a Legend bundle, so I guess that's kind of cool. And if you get top 100, you get 1 Fire Fantasy Pack, and then you get 4 Legend Fantasy Packs. Pretty much you get everything from Legend plus a Fire Fantasy Pack, which is pretty cool. Next, guys, Zero Chill. Tune into Good Morning Madden for Zero Chill information later next week. We'll be sharing more information about existing recurring promos, releases, time shifts during the holiday break. You guys do know they do disappear during the holiday break at some point, so pretty much they'll give us a whole schedule of what's going to be coming towards the end by Christmas when they do leave. Now, Zero Chill, if I had to guess, guys, since it's later next week, so we'll probably know about it around the 9th, 14th. I'm assuming Zero Chill starts around the 14th, 15th, and lasts all the way up to the end of Christmas, presents-wise, right? Now, if you guys already know, I am leaving tomorrow. I am going to Zerk's house for the weekend, spending some time down there, so I will be pre-recording some stuff for you guys as well. Don't worry about that. But just letting you guys know, luckily, nothing's coming out this weekend, so we have a pretty dead weekend, so it kind of works out. Competitive MCS rule update. The Bo-Nose X-Factor will be banned from MCS play. How ironic. You can still use it, guys, for regular people. You can still use it on regs, Weekend League. But how ironic they just... How do you release something and then ban it days later? Running with the quarterbacks for positive yards in RPA on an RPO play will be remain banned under review for today's title update. The Mutt team and gameplay team are reviewing Bo's current AP based on team's feedback, whatever. Yeah, okay. First play with Kendall Fuller. We still have more stuff, by the way, so don't dip out yet. Kendall Fuller, 92 speed, 95 Excel, 89 agility, 89 jumping, 94 play rec, 95 man, 92 zone, 92 press. Great lockdown card. I wish he was like 1 speed faster, but 93 speed with 96 excel with great lockdown coverage stats is still really good nonetheless. He's definitely still one of the best cornerbacks in the game. Again, he's not going to be the best or even maybe top 5, strictly because of the fact that he's not going to go ahead and just get... He's not going to get that pure speed, right, which is going to keep you in the long term. Now, if you are a Washington football theme team or whatever other teams he's been on, you will still go ahead and actually be able to get him up pretty high, and he'll be pretty insane. But the speed's like 1 or 2 notches slower, considering we're turning towards like 94 wide speed wide receivers, 94 speed running backs. Like, we have Bo at 95 powered up, we have wide receivers at 94-95, we have Tyreek Hill. You know, you got to start making corners that can defend them. Next, as we have DeAndre Swift, he actually did just get hurt, which does suck in real life. He was kind of killing it this year on a really bad team, which is makes it way more impressive actually. But 92 speed again. The card looks pretty good, but the problem is that speed. Like, we have Bo Jackson, 95 speed, DeAndre Swift, and 93 powered up. But let's just go base, right? 92 versus 94. 2 speed difference, and he's not a huge guy. Like, he's only, like, 217. Like, he's not going to have that crazy Madden weight. He doesn't get the speed. His excel's great. His agility's great. His change of direction's great. He's a great receiving back. He's great at everything. He's really a well-rounded back in real life. He can break tackles. He can juke. He's super elusive. Like, the fact that he has an 80 catching, right, and probably 80 route running, and he's still an elusive back tells you all you need to know about how good of a runner he is. He's a pure runner while also being a great catcher. Moving forward, guys, we have some Xbox Series X and PS5 updates here. So we have new X-Factor Superstar players, improvements to defending RPOs, and various franchise issues fixed. So, new X-Factor players have Kyler Murray, Dak Prescott, Josh Allen, quarterback, Cooper Kupp, Terry McLaurin, Cameron Hayward, Metcalf. Now, in terms of franchise, guys, you guys understand if you play franchise, Kyler Murray, Dak, and Josh Allen being upgraded is absolutely huge, because for quarterbacks, you only start Quarterbacks are the hardest position to dev up in franchise because you can only dev them up once per season. So if you want to go from a normal to X-Factor quarterback, it could take 4 seasons. If you want to go from superstar to X-Factor, it could take 1 or even 2. Primarily because to be an X-Factor player, you have to be a top 4 passing and touchdowns. And, you know, with injuries and games you can't make, and if you're in a 32 online league, you understand how hard it could be sometimes to even place there when you have guys like Mahomes, Lamar, you know, and so on and so forth, just going at it every year, right? So the difference between a superstar and an X-Factor quarterback is a superstar gets 2 abilities and X-Factor gets 5 abilities in an X-Factor. It's just night and day. That's when you get Hot Route Master. That's when you get Protected. That's when you get Conductor. That's when you get Escape Artist, Dashing Deadeye, Fast Break. Like, all those abilities are tiers 3, 4, and 5. So it is so huge. So if you guys play franchise, the Cardinals and Cowboys just got really good. Cardinals got even better. Josh Allen, Bills got even better. And then, I mean, in terms of wide receivers, I don't really care about X-Factor too much. I mean, I really just care about the superstars. Now, upgraded superstar Justin Herbert. By the way, this is what tells you this, is that Madden does these title updates weeks in advance, and they're just so outdated at this point. Like, Kyler Murray has been hurt and hasn't played in weeks. Now he gets X-Factor? No. They're basing this off his first 4 or 5 weeks and giving it to him now, which is, like, 8 weeks too late, basically. Like, we've been wanting this since week 2. Justin Herbert got it, though, so that, again, in terms of franchise, starting at star is just horrible sometimes. They start a superstar, which is going to mean they'll be 99 pretty fast, as well as they'll have abilities to start, which is awesome. Debo Samuel. And remember, abilities given by Madden are always better than abilities earned by Madden, if you guys understand what I'm saying. So players that start with abilities, Madden gives them really good abilities because they know what they're good at. When you actually go and upgrade Justin Herbert on your own, Madden will literally give him, like, stupidest. Like, he'll give him, like, agile extender and, like, long range. Like, he'll give him some super stuff. Like, it won't give him anything running wise, like, in terms of, like, escape artist. So when Madden gives it to you, it comes out a lot better, actually. So it's very exciting to see them start. Debo Samuel, Austin Eckler, Wyatt Teller. That's big for the Browns. The Browns had an insane O-line, but they're all-star. Lattimore, finally, after like 7 years, they give him something, right? Trevon Diggs, that was fat. That kind of messed up that Trevon Diggs gets it first year doing well, and Lattimore's been pretty good for like 7 years. He just gets it. Matthew Judone, Mike Williams gets it. Jamar Chase. Jamar Chase, I think, started with it. I think Jamar Chase had it already. It was just that as a rookie, he had it. I guess this is for reg rosters, though. Vita Vey. Mark Andrews, that's great. I'm the Ravens, so I wish I would have had that already, because tight ends also are very hard to dev up. They, like, don't get dev games, and they also don't, they, like, glitch. Like, they don't progress. Ryan Jensen, that's pretty cool. Downgraded to superstar. Julio Jones, Jamal Adams, Michael Thomas, J.J. Watt, Devin McCourty, Xavier Howard. Biggest ones here are probably Jamal Adams and Julio. Like, that's wild. Michael Thomas, I guess I could see that one coming. J.J. Watt as well, wow. Now, no abilities. Saquon Barkley, Odell, Kenny. As a Giants fan, I hate to see this. Saquon Barkley, Odell, and Kenny Galladay. Saquon Barkley's good. That's messed up. He's been hurt. Odell, I guess I can see why that one. Kenny Galladay, I can see why that one too. Allen Robinson, Josh Allen, defensive end. Cole Beasley, Trent Brown. And gameplay updates. Added logic for defenders to attack the quarterback more aggressively when scrambling on RPO and wide receiver screenplays. That's cool. Added logic for defenders to recognize ineligible players downfield in RPO and screenplays so they can break into pursuit fast. So RPO glitch should be dead. Tuning to improve the pursuit of pitch and read defenders in RPO replays so they'll pursue the quarterback when he keeps the ball. Fix an issue causing the read defenders to tackle the wide receiver in RPOs. Fix an issue causing tight end streaks to make an outside release stem at the beginning of the route. Tuning kick power so players with 99 kick power and they have the capability to make 66-yard field goals in the right conditions. That is awesome. That is awesome because I have Justin Tucker in franchise. I'm pretty sure he's 99 kick power. So that does mean he can really nail some field goals now. That's pretty cool. Fix an issue sometimes preventing defensive player from making adjustments after flipping the play. Okay, cool. That's cool as well. Fixed, improved a DB press animation that was taking the receiver too far off his route. Fixed an issue preventing player from showing up in co-op online franchises. Tuning to improve tight ends catching the ball in flat when thrown by a CPU quarterback. All right, and the franchise updates, guys, really horrible stuff. I mean, you guys can screenshot this if you'd like. Nothing that I personally see in franchise that I really want to fix. I would prefer the user glitch being fixed. That's about it, guys. Hopefully you did enjoy. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Turn the notification bell. Give this video a big thumbs up, as always. And, of course, comment down below. Thank you for watching. I'm out. Peace.